Yo, what's going on, everybody? Akeem here, and in today's Fix of Entertainment News, we break down the mass exodus of both users and employees at Twitter. Like, what's Elon Musk doing exactly? Now, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Stone Ocean's final episode's release date, and Wakanda Forever asserts dominance at the box office. Let's drop it. Now, there's a lot going on over at Twitter, with a lot of Twitter employees not being on board with what Elon Musk is dubbing hardcore Twitter 2.0. I don't know if Elon ever heard of the saying, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, but it seems he's hell-bent on forcing us to cop up $8 and a slew of other unnecessary action items just to share our thoughts on the social media platform. And now a bunch of Twitter employees are locked out of Twitter HQ as Elon and his leadership are scared some of their employees might sabotage the company from the inside. So they're doing some weird covert ops to try and find out which employees are suspect and need to have their access cut. That's kind of crazy to see a man with a lot of money buy a company for a lot of money, only to burn said money-making machine to the ground in an odd attempt to supposedly upset the masses. I personally don't care enough about Twitter, as it's not my most popular social media platform, but you know, it's rather entertaining to watch everyone so upset about it and going to Twitter to post how upset they are about the impending changes. How about, you know, you just leave the damn platform if you're so upset about it? And it appears some folks are doing just that, with some Twitter users leaving for other social media platforms like Tribal, Discord, and Mastodon. Now, according to a New York Times post, Twitter employees were sent a Google form with the question asking if they'd want to stay with the company given its impending changes, and some employees apparently just opted to post a farewell message on the platform and kiss the company goodbye. That definitely seems Elon's involvement with the company has been the kiss of death for Twitter, with supposedly half of its staff either being fired or resigning. But at least Elon did the right thing, admitting he was wrong in firing Ligma and Johnson, giving them back their jobs. That's a plus. Now, what do y'all think about all of this news, this Twitter debacle? Sound off in the comment section down below. Let's discuss. Curious to know if you plan on leaving the platform. Now, in other news, we got Stone Ocean returning with its final episodes this December, wrapping up Jolene's bizarre story as she kicks ass in a maximum security prison against other Stan users. Now, Netflix dropped the new trailer, and it's honestly looking like it'll live up to the manga. It'll be interesting to see where the JoJo's anime will go from here, as the Stone Ocean series kind of sets up the rest of the franchise in a unique way. Stone Ocean drops the final batch of episodes December 1st. And finally, Black Panther Wakanda Forever is killing it at the box office, scoring $400 million globally. And with an initial domestic intake of $181 million, Wakanda Forever has had the second biggest box office debut of 2022 so far, just behind Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness at $187.4 million. And with the Thanksgiving holiday approaching, Wakanda Forever will undoubtedly continue to welcome in newcomers and big dollars. And that about does it for your entertainment news for today. I'm Akeem LaWanson, and thank y'all so much for watching. Now that you're caught up on today's news, please check out our previous video. Download the IGN app on all your devices, and for everything else, stick with IGN.